On the 13th of September 1848, Phineas Gage survived an accident in which an explosion propelled a large iron bar completely through his head. Welcome to History Pod. Phineas Gage was a railway construction foreman and was directing a team near Cavendish, Vermont to prepare the bedrock for laying new railroad tracks. His role was to pack inert material over explosive powder placed into a drilled hole in order to direct the explosion into the surrounding rock. This involved the use of a tamping iron, a javelin-like metal pole over 3.5 feet long and 1.25 inches in diameter. With his attention briefly distracted by the team of men working behind him, the iron sparked against the rock and ignited the powder that he'd already placed in the hole. The explosion propelled the tamping iron into Gage's left cheek before passing behind his left eye and exiting through the top of his skull, destroying much of his brain's left frontal lobe. Remarkably, Gage did not lose consciousness and was even able to walk with minimal assistance to a nearby cart that transported him to the local doctor. Physicians Edward H. Williams and later John Martin Harlow treated Gage. They cleaned the wound, removed bone fragments, and attempted to reduce the risk of infection. Despite the severity of the injury, Gage survived, and within a few months he was able to return to a semblance of physical health. Nevertheless, Gage's friends and family noticed significant changes in his personality and behaviour. These were attributed to the damage to the frontal lobes of his brain, providing early evidence of the link between brain structure and personality. His case was widely studied, and it influenced early theories of brain function and the development of the field of neuroscience. Gage went on to live for another 12 years, and his skull and the tamping iron that caused his injury are now on display at Harvard Medical School.